a baby, and my name is Promise. And this is my family. They are all beautiful, but they all had bad things happen to them. So my bumblebee started an organization called Saving Promise to help save me and girls like me and help the world be good again.
Well, Promise is a child who inspired her grandmother to work to end intimate partner violence. For five generations, L.Y. Marlowe's family suffered from domestic violence. After the birth of Promise, she decided to create an organization focused on making sure that girls like her granddaughter and others didn't have to endure such trauma. And we welcome her and Donna Seeker to Good Morning Washington.
Thank you.
Welcome,
for having
ladies.
Us.
Yes. So listen, let's talk about this, because the number really say a lot, and that is that 80.9 million experience violent partner abuse in their lifetime, and out of that, some 15.5 million. Mm-hmm. Your family, L.Y., was one of them.
Yeah, five generations of intimate partner violence and domestic violence in my family, and it would be the story of my daughter's little girl named Promise that became the fifth generation that inspired me to launch Saving Promise.
Mm-hmm. So you're launching this campaign. Donna, you stepped in a big way with you as marketing specialist to help with this. Why do you think it's so important to talk about this? Because a lot of times we don't know what's happening with people that we work alongside, people
exactly.
who are our neighbors.
Exactly. You had the statistics, but actually it's one in three women, mm-hmm. one in four men, and one of four children. So it can be any group that you're sitting around the table with that at least one person is affected.
Right.
And that effect has such ramifications for generations and generations. And it doesn't, there's so much shame and stigma, and there doesn't have to be. It's all education levels, economic levels, parts of the country.
Right, yeah. Economic levels, like you mentioned. So we want to create this healthier, safer world. Mm-hmm. How do we do that?
And that's one of the reasons why we are launching a national campaign called Friends of Promise. One thing that we've learned, Veronica, is that it really requires each one of us in the grassroots community to get involved. And so the Friends of Promise campaign is all about asking people to step up and see what we each can do mm-hmm. to help to prevent intimate partner violence, to help build connection to community and have a conversation. You can have a conversation in your workplace, in your homes, in your communities, in your churches, in your schools. And so we're asking people to visit savingpromise.org to learn how they can become a friend of promise.
Mm-hmm, and make a pledge. And it's a hard conversation, Donna, because it's a subject matter that really, I mean, you're taking it out of the shadows and you're trying to put it into the light and discuss something that is so heavy with someone at times.
It is. But if we can, as so many things have come to light in recent times, if we can build a community to form a connection, and then we won't be so, that conversation won't be so hard to have. Mm-hmm. Because we want to prevent it, prevent more abuse from happening. And how do you do that? You educate, mm-hmm. you discuss.
And of course, October is National Domestic Violence Awareness Month. The hope here is to impact young girls or youngsters at the earliest age possible, right?
That's what prevention is all about, Veronica. Prevention is about having that conversation as early as possible. Grade school age kids like Promise is.
L.Y. and Donna, thank you so very much. For more information so that folks can make a pledge and get the necessary information to at least start the conversation, where do they go?
Visit savingpromise.org and learn how you can become a friend of promise.
Thank you so very much, ladies. All right.